we were about to discuss with what? With W data blending, right? Yeah, data merging or whatever. Okay, here we go, guys. So as I said, right, to perform the data merging, right, so what we should have, what is the thumb rule? The thumb rule is we should have a common dimension as well as the matching record we should have, then only we can perform the merging, right? That is what the outcome, as we discussed in yesterday's session, right? So in our scenario, we are picking up from different sources of our data, and then we are trying to generate a consolidated report. That is what our ultimate target here. So it could be two different data sources or databases, two files or whatever you call it as, okay, from two different data sources. Okay, so it doesn't mean that, you know, we should have only two data sources. No, you should have, you might have multiple data sources, but the first one is treated as a primary one, and the later on whatever you are treating it as, those are all secondary data sources. So primary data sources and secondary data sources, guys. Okay, so these two are the rules. That is what I told you, right? One is we should have a common dimension, and another one is we should have at least one matching record in both the common dimensions in between two different data sources. Okay, so guys, basically this data merging, right, can be achievable in two ways. Can be achievable in two ways. One is tool will take care of it. That is what automatic data blending. Okay, and another one is manual blending, manual data blending. So data blending can be done, can be achievable in two ways. One is automatic data blending, and another one is manual data blending. Okay, so let me show you right away with some flat files how we can extract, I mean how we can perform the data blending right away. Let's have a look. Of course, since it is my local laptop, I do not have any data sources, guys. Probably whenever I'm going to show you with how to interact with the different databases like SQL Server and all, at that moment, if you want, I can show you that connectivity. But at this moment, I'm trying to focus on with flat files. Okay, here we go. Yeah. So let me check the flat files what I have with me. I think I have, no, not SAP. So data source one. Let's say I have one data source. And it is having like PID as well as some values. Let me show you that in a file. Look at this. What I have? Some PID and sales in India. Okay, so some PIDs like this. Okay, that is what I have. Now look at your this one. Okay, now go to worksheet. Okay, so I'm keeping it as what? Data blending. So don't forget about all these things, guys. This is what? Naming conventions. We should stick on to it. Okay, fine. Now at this moment, what is the data source? This data source is pointing towards India, right? Now look at this. So let me have a PID here. Okay, so this is the PID, and then sales in India is the measure I have here. Okay, fine. So let me have a text values here. Yep. Right, guys. Fine. Now, so at this moment, how many data sources we have? Only one data source. Okay, only one data source. Guys, I am at this moment, I am focusing on what? Automatic data blending. Okay. Now I have one data source. To include one more data source, what was the thumb rule? The thumb rule is you should have common dimension between primary data source and secondary data source. We should have common dimension. Now let me show you the data source two. What is the common dimension? PID is the common dimension. Okay. And if you look at here, this is the common record I have between sheet 1, I'm going to say data source 1 and data source 2. Okay, that is the common element I have. Fine. Now look at this. How I can embed them into my existing worksheet? Simple. Go to data source. Okay. Add new. Okay. No, not this one. go to this one, add a new here, okay, add a new. Now what is the file? Text file. So I'm going to choose data source 2. See, data source 2, I have these records. Okay, so now again go to your worksheet. Now look at this. This one at this moment it is not checked, which means it is not being used. That is what the intention. Okay, now look at this. So data source 1, which is related to India, data source 2 is related to UK. Fine. Now what am I going to do? Look at this, guys. Whenever I am trying to add the sales of UK, okay, what happened? Okay, you know the reason, because okay, we have
Aman here.
Yes, Aman.
So Ganesh, here basically, you know, the common dimension means, say, the common dimension, the name and data type, length, everything will be same, or exactly what is the criteria?
Exactly. Your point will come in picture at manual blending. Okay. I'll touch base your points. Okay.
Okay.
Just give me 10 minutes.
Sure.
Now look at this, guys. So let me add again one more data source. Look at this. The new data source I'm trying to add. Let's say. Fine. Now go to my worksheet. Now look at this. Guys, if you observe clearly, you have data source 1 and data source 2. But data source 2 element is not being used. But look at this. What is this, guys? This is what? An automatic dimension. I mean automatic blending. Fine. Look at this. What happened? In between source 1, it is nothing but primary source is data source 1, secondary source is data source 2. What happened? A data merging, I mean it's a data blending is automatically happened because the left outer join has been, okay, left outer join between the primary data and secondary data is been applicable here. So that is the reason you are able to see these results. Okay, look at this. Sales UK, which is a common data. The whole data of a left side table along with the common values of the opposite side table, isn't it? So here the left side table is what? Data source 1. And the right side table is what? Data source 2. That is what? Secondary resource. So primary resource is related to India. Secondary resource is related to UK. So that is the reason it is giving the common value. Along with this, it is giving a common value, isn't it? So but here, the data blending is being performed automatically. Look at this. I'm disabling this. Now look at this. I'm enabling this. You no need to also, basically. Okay. It will be taken care automatically. Look at this blending. It's a kind of a chain symbol. Okay. Linking. So because it is being linked based upon what? Based upon the common column. Based upon the common column, the linking has been applicable here. So that is the reason. Okay. Now, if I break down this in, yes. Yes, Aman. Okay. See, this linking has been performed automatically. This is what? Automatic blending. Basically, what happened, you know? Left outer join functionality has been performed. Okay, and moreover, keep in mind, guys, it doesn't mean that, you know, you should have only two data sources. No, you might have five data sources, fine, but whatever you are defining over here, this is the primary, and later on whatever you are appending it, those are all treated as a secondary data sources, and those are all can be called as secondary data sources, and which is working as a left outer join functionality with primary data source. Okay, So what the left outer join will do, all the left side tables, all the data from the left side table along with the common values of the opposite side table. So what is the common value? If you look at your data sources, 895 is the common data. So that is the reason it is showing in this way. Okay, so that is what. But here, guys, you are not supposed to forget this. This is an automatic blending, okay? Automatic data blending. But basically, whenever it is doing a blending in an automatic way, it will follow some order at the backend level. First, it will refer some if it is having any geographic dimensions. And the second category goes to date dimension, and the third one is textual dimensions. It follows this kind of a order. Okay, that is what automatic blending. Now, the another one which we are supposed to focus on, manual blending. Okay. Now, what Aman was asking, Aman is saying that does the naming convention of the common dimensions, is that should be exactly same? No. Sometimes you might have a different naming convention. Now, look at this. For example, here I have products, something like this. Okay. Now, if you observe clearly, I don't have a common dimension between data source 1 and data source 2. Then it doesn't mean that, you know, we are not going to perform the data blending. No, you can. That can be achievable through data manual merging or manual data blending. Okay, that can be achievable in this way, guys. Here we go. So let me put it, this is, let's say, automatic. That is what automatic data blending. Okay. Now, the another one I'm touch basing is what? Manual data blending. Okay. So this manual data blending will come in picture whenever you have inconsistency in terms of naming conventions or whatever it is. Okay. Now, let me refresh it. Both the data sources. Okay, now look at this. Data source 1, data source 2, I do not have any common dimension. Then, how am I going to perform this? Isn't it? Now, okay, let's see. So basically, let me pull out this PID and say it's fine. Now, come down to this one. So let me add sales UK. Fine. That is fine. Now, what you need to do, select that second data source, go to worksheet. Okay, we have an option called edit relationships. So sorry, not at worksheet, at a data level. Okay, select the second data source, go to data. What is this? Edit relationship. Okay, now here we have to define what is primary data source and what is secondary data source. Whatever, you might have thousands of data sources, I don't care. Irrespective of it, you have to define what are all the secondary data sources you have it. Okay, now look at this. The primary data source is DS1 and secondary data source is obviously DS2. Now, I don't want to have it in automatic way. I would like to have it in a customized way. Okay, custom. Now, just add. So what is that? Now look at this. PID, product. Now you have to merge. You have to do a field mapping between source 1 and to source 2. See, PID and product, likewise, okay? And then click OK. See, now what happened? Look at this. Okay, now again, based upon the product, the merging, the data blending has been happened. So this is what, okay? This is what? Manual data blending, okay? So here what happened? Again, left outer join functionality has been happened. Look at this, guys. For example, let's say, okay, the primary data source, okay, and the secondary data sources. You might have so many data sources, secondary data sources, 1, 3, 4, 5, 10, or whatever. But the left outer join is affecting on the primary data source, okay. So that is what, okay. So with this, okay, we can say that the data blending is happening a concept of left outer join functionality. Okay, guys, irrespective of the number of secondary data sources, the left outer join is working on the primary data sources. Okay, so this is what. Now you can ask me a question. Can we shuffle primary to secondary, secondary to primary? Why not? Absolutely, you can shuffle it. Look at this. Go to edit relationships over here. Okay, you can edit it. So, I mean, not here, over here, I can say. Okay, so primary data source becomes data source 2 and secondary becomes DS1. Likewise, you can shuffle it, not an issue. Okay, but you have to do this activity manually. So when this situation will come in picture, whenever you see the inconsistency between the column naming conventions, then only we'll be going ahead with the this kind of a manual data blending. Okay, guys. Aman, is that answer your question, Aman?
Yes. So Ganesh, here always if it is a left outer join, so I have a case where I want to know extract data from right outer, even full outer, some cases. So it's not a good practice. So if that is the case, then what will be the scenario?
Yeah, if that is the case, you need to play around with the joins over here. I mean, whenever we are playing with the joins here, right? Instead of having a...
Yeah, I understand, Ganesh, but see, joins, if the tables are underlying in one database, I can use joins. But here, data is originating from Excel, and one more data is from Oracle. So how can I use joins?
Exactly. So that is a valid point then. So if that is the case, right? But as per the practices of a Tableau, right, it is recommended that the data blending follows only a left outer join. If you have a scenario such like a, I mean, like with the different data sources, if you want to have a full fledged data, then it is not recommended. Okay, man, this is the best practice, I can say. I'm not saying that it is not possible. It is possible, but it is the best practice to give up as per the nature of the tool behavior. Okay.
Okay, probably it will be the disadvantage of the data blending.
I agree with that.
Okay.
Okay, guys, and one more thing is, okay, but manual data blending never follows any order, guys, okay? So what you can do, right, with this different example, so whatever the example I have shown you, this is only one example. So what you can do, right, you can take out the help of the Tableau itself. You can try with the different examples. Okay, let me show you that. Probably it can be definitely helpful for you. Sorry, guys. Tableau. What is that? See, data blending. Where am I? Understand maybe it's fine. We have already gone through it. Okay. See how to add a secondary resource. No, all those things. Probably you can try to have a primary group. Okay. See, this is what edit relationships. We are trying to give alias names also. That is also possible. Okay. But that is fine. Yeah. See, look at this, guys. We have some generic example here. Okay. So try to have a practice with this example. Okay. Which is some graphs, okay? That is also possible. Try to have a workaround, okay? And if you don't have any matching data, it will give you null values like this. So. Right, guys, try to have a workaround with this. Okay, try to, this is another example that I can help you out with this. Okay, yeah, right, guys, that is one thing. Okay, so any questions with data blending, guys? I'm pretty sure that I'm going to share you that with the different data sources, that is fine, but ultimately, concept and approach is same. Irrespective of the data source, it could be text, or it could be Excel, it could be MS Access, it could be RDBMS, it could be MS BI Cubes, or it could be SAP BW Cubes. I don't care. Approach is 100% similar, guys. So don't forget that. So that is the reason I'm pretty confident enough that you are going to understand with the different data sources also. And that too, whenever I'm going to touch base with the server concept, I'm going to show you how to interact with the other data sources. Okay, other data sources like MySQL or SQL Server, something like that. Okay, but keep in mind, irrespective of the data source, the mode of development of a Tableau worksheet or Tableau dashboard never ever differ. It is 100% same. Okay, whatever we are going through it at this moment. Okay, guys. Yeah. Now, any questions, guys? Please. Bhargavi, Giri, Harish, Prasad, Radhika, Ramakrishna, Aman. Any questions, please?
Hey, Ganesh, Aman here. Sorry for asking you so many questions.
No problem, Aman. I am here to clarify the questions. Okay, no problem. Don't worry.
Yeah, Ganesh, actually, you know, as we are discussing about blended topics, so I have a question, like, what is meant by blended access?
Exactly, it's a good point. Okay. See, look at this. Blended access, right? We are already covered this blended access. Look at this. See, this blended access, it comes in terms of a, okay. Blended access is something different, okay. So blended access will come in picture to deal with the measures. Okay, let me show you right away, okay. Of course, this we are already discussed. Blended access is something different, and data blending is totally different. So don't compare with, but since you are asking, I'm touch base this point. Okay, again, I'll touch base it. Now look at
this. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no problem. So basically, the blended access, right? It is nothing but it is a mixing of your X axis and axis. Okay, but mixing or amalgamation. Okay, because to deal with the multiple measures in a single graph, okay, we used to have this blended access. For example, let's say now, look at this. Let's say I have an element called category, okay, and I have multiple measures. Let's say discount and then sales. Okay. Let me put in this way, or else we can do one thing. Now, look at this. I have discount at this moment. Now, what am I trying to do? The sales. Okay. What I did, look at here. I'm dealing with the multiple axes here, right? See, over here, one is dealing with the discount values and another one is dealing with the sales axis, isn't it? I mean to say multiple measures. Okay. X axis is common, but I do have what? Multiple measures. So this multiple measures, sometimes look at this, here you have number 10, but here you have 10k, 20k, 30k, 40k, I mean to say thousands, but this is number 10, 23, 43, something like that. But if you look at here, these axes are different, right? So what am I going to do is, so this blended axis is basically to deal with the multiple measures with a common X axis. Look at this, one is discount and another one is sales. To make sure that the scales should be in same, then I'm going to use synchronized access. Now look at this. This also has been fallen into 10K, 20K, 30K, like that. Okay. So in this case, blended access in the sense with a common X axis, I'm going to deal with the multiple measures. In case if the scale is not in synchronized with the other opposite measure, then I'm going to synchronize the axis. So this is what blended access, which is exclusively to refer multiple measures. Okay, Aman, is that answer your question?
Yeah, Ganesh, but it's almost similar to dual access, Ganesh.
Yeah.
Is there any difference between a blended access and dual access?
Yeah, Dual access is something different. Look at this. Dual access requires gate functionality. Okay, I mean majority time. So dual access is a combination of. Okay, look at this. Let me put in this way. Now look at this. This is what dual access. Okay, dual access is something different. If you observe clearly, look at this. This green color is indicating profit, and the blue bars are indicating discount. This is dual access. In dual access, okay, it is recommended to show, represent the data in this way. Even if you look at this one, right? See, this is what dual access. Okay.
Okay, thank you, Ganesh.
No problem, sir. No problem. So, dual access and blended access both are different. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. So, probably you can do one thing, Aman. Still, if you have any questions, right, try to go through this video record where we were discussing at the initial, I mean, say, initial sessions. So, go through it. If you have any questions, just let me know. I can help you out further. Okay?
Sure. Thank you, Ganesh.
No problem, sir. Yeah. Okay, guys. Now, let me touch base with the concept of charts. Okay? Charts. Because we have different types of charts, guys. Okay? We have different types of charts. Like, I can say, like, it is just like as per normal practices. It doesn't mean that it is only applicable to advanced reporting tools. Even in traditional tools also, you have this kind of a charting functionalities. Like, you have like a line chart, bar chart, plenty of stuff. Okay, so let's touch base those types and when it is recommended and when it is not recommended. So let's discuss in that point of view. Okay, here we go, guys. So, yeah, we have a concept of what? Charts. Basically, I mean, as per the normal practices, I'm not comparing with any traditional or I'm not comparing with any advanced tools. This is a normal practice. Okay. The charts has been categorized into three different types, guys. Okay. Charts has been categorized into three different types. One is univariate charts. Okay. Univariate charts and bivariate charts and multivariate charts. What is that? Univariate, bivariate, multivariate. So the charts has been classified based upon the representation of a data, right? These charts has been classified in different ways like this. Univariate, bivariate, multivariate. How they are being classified it? Okay. That is based upon the usage of number of measurable elements. It has been classified in this way. Okay. Right, guys. Okay. It is being classified in this way. Like, look at this. Univariate is whenever we are using and analyzing the chart with only one measure, that is being treated as a univariate chart. Okay. It is being treated as what? Univariate chart. Okay. And bivariate in the sense, in case if the analysis is with multiple measures, okay. If the analysis is with multiple measures, okay, then the bivariate will come in picture. With multiple measures, with only two measures. Okay, with two measures. If the analysis you are doing with two measures, that is what called as bivariate. Then how about multivariate? Multivariate in the sense, if you are performing the analysis with more than two measures, that is what called as multivariate charts. Okay, guys, this is what your mathematics. Okay, I can say it is, yeah, it is a mathematics, trigonometry, right? So based upon the categorization of these charts, right, how are we going to develop a Tableau related stuff? Okay, isn't it? So here we go, guys. Let me show you right away. But I think we have almost like 20 to 25. I'm not pretty, not exactly sure about the count, but we have more than different representation of a charts, more than like 20 to 25 guys. Okay, but each and every notation of a graph, like those 25 types, is having their own identities, own representation of a data. Okay, so anyhow, let me show you right away. Okay, let me show you right away how it is going to be implemented in our W dashboards. Let's see it right away, guys. Okay, here we go. Okay, yeah, fine. Now look at this, guys. Let's say I have category and I have some measure. Look at this. What is this? Line chart. Why it is not enabled? You know why? It requires, because line chart is recommended for the analysis over a period of time. Guys, you know why I am briefing this? Because being as a Tableau developer, you should be in a position to propose, hey, for this kind of a data, this is recommended. Hey, for this kind of a data, this graph is recommended. You should be in a position to justify that. That is the reason I am taking up this, especially this concept, okay? Because if someone asks you, hey boss, I have this kind of a data, can you suggest me what kind of a graph is recommended? Then you are not supposed to think, isn't it? You should say that, yes boss, so you are trying to do the periodical analysis of your data in your graph. So that is the reason, try to use line chart. This is the nature of this. Likewise, you should be in a position to justify that. Then only you can say that, yes, I am a master of a Tableau, right? Just dragging and dropping, anyone can do, guys. That is not a big deal. You should have that conceptual knowledge in terms of, based upon the nature of a data, which is recommended and what is not recommended, like that. Okay. Yeah. Now look at this. When this line chart is recommended, see, whenever I have some kind of a category or whatever it is, I have multiple measures. Look at this. This line chart is not getting enabled because, you know, the line chart is exclusively recommended if you are performing the analysis, okay, over a period of time. What is that? Period of time. Then only the line chart is recommended. Otherwise, you have bar chart or whatever, I don't care, okay, something like that, isn't it? So now, that is the reason. Keep in mind, guys, line chart is recommended whenever you are trying to perform analytics with over a period of time, then only line chart is recommended. Okay. Now look at this. Very simple, guys. Now look at this. Instead of category, what am I trying to do? Period of time. I'm going to add order date. Now look at this. Automatically, look at this. It has been enabled. Okay. Right, guys, this is what line chart. Okay, now look at this. What kind of a line chart it is? Line continuous. Continuous in the sense, did you remember this, guys? The continuous is occurring here. Okay, now if I choose data discrete, what happened? Discrete, it is keep on changing automatically. Okay, look at this. If I choose, look at this, for lines inside a bracket, what you have? Continuous. Look at this. Continuous. One date, zero or more dimension, but one or more measure. Isn't it? So date is compulsory. Zero or more dimensions. Dimension is not compulsion. In case if you have, that is fine. Now look at this. Okay. See, example. Isn't it? That's how it works. Okay, guys. So look at this. So continuous. Continuous in the sense, because this is a date functionality, right? So it will be showing continuous automatically. Okay. Now, if I go ahead with this, it will show you discrete. Discrete. Look at the nature. Discrete. This is what the nature here. Okay. Discrete and then lines. Okay. But for discrete, right, now you can ask me a question. Can't we use multiple measures? You can use whatever you want, guys. No restriction at all. purely as per your requirement basis. Okay, that's it. It's purely requirement basis. See, look at this.
Okay.
Okay. So this is what line continuous, line discrete. Line continuous, line discrete. Okay. Now what is this? You have what? Dual lines. Dual lines will come in picture. Okay. Look at this. Okay. Dual lines. Okay, which means more than one measure. Look at this. More than one measure if you have dual measure. It doesn't mean that, you know, you have only two measures. It depends upon the need basis, guys. See, three measures. This is what? Okay? Like that. Two measures. Okay? Fine. Right, guys. And you have dual combination. Dual combination in sense, one is line chart and another one is bar chart. That is what? Dual combination. Now look at here. Here, the axes are not in sync with discount and to the quantity. Now what you can do? You have what? You have an option of what? But why it is not showing a synchronized axis here? Definitely. Because the nature of graph itself is different. This is a dual combination. So you cannot do a synchronized axis here. Okay. But if you remember the blended axis we were discussing, right? There you can do. Okay. So likewise. Right, guys? So in this way, you can play around with the dual lines. Dual lines in the sense, one date, multiple measures. Okay. Right, guys? So now, we have one more concept called, okay, this one. Area chart. Look at this. Area charts. Okay. This area charts come up with the portioning the data. Portioning. Nothing but occupation. How much portion it is being occupied. Look at this. Okay. Likewise. Right, guys. So, isn't it? One or more measures. Up to you. As per your need basis. See. Okay. See. This is what called area chart, which is continuous. Again, look at this. Which is continuous again. Look at this. Area chart of continuous. Again, if I touch base this one, area chart of discrete. Look at this. Discrete. Okay. So, you should understand the differences, guys. Okay. So, don't forget that. Right. So, this is the way to deal with the area chart, which is continuous, which is discrete. Okay. So, but these area charts come up with the portionizing. I mean, portion in the sense, how much of occupation it is being done. In this way, it represents, guys. So, this is what? Line charts. So, when line chart is recommended? Line chart is recommended whenever we are performing over a period of time. Okay. Look at the years. This is a periodical data. 2014, 2013, 2012, 2011. Periodical data. So, whenever you are dealing in this way, yep, the line chart is recommended. Okay, guys. Thank you. Thanks for your time.